Hello everyone, so today what we are going to cover is the very important, and today it was asked in the oral, and it was regarding, it is associated with the CO2 flooding system. Okay, so we are going to cover the safety devices on CO2 flooding system. We'll first look at what all safety devices are there, and then we'll go on brief, and after that we'll describe it in detail. First of all, we see, look at it at in brief. We have master valve with alarm switch. We have relief valves at manifold. We have stop valve and pull handle, lock release cabinet and alarm switch. We have safety bursting disc at each CO2 bottle. We have leakage detecting pressure switch on manifold. Non-return discharge valve after CO2 bottles. We have pressure gauges, pressure switch. We have check valve, time delay unit and safety pin. So these are important. We are going to cover up some important ones in detail. So first of all, let's talk about the bursting. It is very important. The pressure of CO2 inside the bottle depends on the temperature of the surroundings. As temperature increases, pressure also increases. Therefore, to safeguard against abnormally high pressure inside the bottle, a bursting disc is provided. Okay, on the head assembly, as shown in the figure I have shown you down below, when the CO2 pressure inside the bottle increases to about 200 bar, bursting disc burst and releases CO2 to the CO2 room. Pressure inside the bottle build up to such a high value means there is a fire inside CO2 room. Here, CO2 released from the bottle itself extinguishes fire inside the room. So you look at the picture over here. So this is the bursting disc. You have hose connections. We have flexible hoses. Even in earlier video, I've also covered for regulations and requirement for a CO2 room, so that also you can watch if you have not. Each bottle has a combined bursting disc which will rupture spontaneously at pressure of 177 bar at 63 degrees Celsius. Now, you also know that CO2 room also has heating arrangement when it is in colder climate. So there are insulations which are provided. Pressure gauge and pressure alarm in the manifold. We have pressure gauges as well as pressure alarm in the manifold. So this is self-explanatory. We also have check valve fitted on the connection pipe between each cylinder discharge valve and manifold, so that leakage of one cylinder cannot affect other cylinder. So that is the reason we have check valve. We have exhaust fan and suction duct provided at the bottom of the CO2 room. Any accumulated CO2 from leakage at the bottom can be exhausted to the atmosphere. This is also covered in requirement and regulation in detail, what type of fan it must be, where the exhaust should lead to, what is the distance between the accommodation and the exhaust duct. So all these have been covered in the previous video, requirement for CO2 room. You can watch that. We also have dip tube. The function of a dip tube is to deliver liquid carbon dioxide outside the bottle. Okay, so it is very important and very necessary. If the dip tube is not provided, CO2 evaporates from the surface while discharge, taking latent heat of vaporization, and remaining liquid CO2 will freeze inside. Hence, failure of CO2 discharge. Therefore, it is necessary to operate CO2 fire extinguisher in upright position. So there are two precautions while operating a CO2, whether it is a portable one or whether it is fixed CO2 bottles. We have dip tube in both the cases. Wherever a CO2 fire extinguisher, irrespective of the size, we have dip tube. We have relief valves at manifold. There is a relief valve fitted in the manifold of CO2 flooding system. Function of the relief valve is to release the CO2 pressure. So we are releasing the CO2 pressure in the manifold to the atmosphere outside CO2 room. Such a situation arises when CO2 gets released from the bottle and master valve is still closed. Okay, so pressure of relief valve is about 180 bar. Again, set pressure varies with the system and design. If the pressure of fluid in a pipeline increases beyond the designed working pressure, there must be a pressure relief mechanism, because if the line pressure increases and the master valve is closed, so what will happen? The line, because all the bottles are highly pressurized, so the line pressure will increase, which can cause rupture. So there is a relief valve which is provided to safeguard the system. In the case of CO2 flooding system, CO2 will accumulate in the manifold. When it is released from the bottle and master valve is closed, pressure of CO2 is 55 bar at 20 degrees Celsius. As CO2 takes temperature from surrounding, its pressure also increases to dangerous levels. Since these pipes are pressure tested at 190 bar only, a relief valve is necessary in the manifold. Any pressure accumulate in the manifold may release other CO2 bottle which are intact if the non-return valve between bottle and manifold is damaged. So there are two reasons for providing a relief valve. One was that to protect the line, okay, because if there is a leakage, because bottles are highly pressurized, so the line will, what will happen, the line will get rupture. And the second reason why it is being provided is because of this, that it may affect the other bottle. Now we have function of pressure switch, pressure gauge in manifold. Pressure switch is fitted in the common manifold to identify any leakage of CO2 gas from bottles. You must be seeing a box, white colored box directly mounted on the line. So that is pressure switch. The pressure switch activate warning alarm for the leakage. Similarly, pressure switch will activate alarms while actual operation of CO2 flooding system. A pressure gauge is also fitted on the manifold to read any gas pressure inside. A valve for pressure testing of the system is also connected to the pressure gauge connection. As so we have missed the line diagram though. So now we have time delay unit in the CO2 flooding system. So this is very important because it is directly associated and linked to the safety of human life. In fact, CO2 is itself affected because one or the two question you may find in from the CO2 system. The other being is that the time delay unit in this system, in release cabinet, reaches main bottle head assembly through a time delay unit. Okay, so the main bottle assembly, CO2 from the pilot bottles in release cabinet reaches the CO2 bottles head assembly through a time delay unit. Function of this time delay unit is to delay the supply of CO2 to the head assembly to 60 to 90 seconds. In other words, when valve 2 in the release cabinet is opened, there is a numbering of valve which is there and provided. So there is a numbering of valve in valve 2 in the release cabinet is opened. CO2 reaches only after 60 to 90 seconds to the head assembly. So it also depends on the system and the design, what is the requirement. Reason for providing such a delay in the CO2 flooding system are given below. So as soon as the CO2 cabinet open, alarm is sounded in the protected space. A time delay of 60 to 90 seconds gives sufficient time for personnel to, so that there is a time for personnel to evacuate. In CO2 released from the main bottles to the common manifold, before opening master valve, there may be a difficulty in opening master valve because of bulk CO2 pressure acting on it. Because of the time delay, positive opening of the master valve is ensured before. Regulation of the time delay can be achieved in different way. Out of these, two type of time delay unit is commonly used in CO2 flooding system on board ship. One is electrical type, which has an AC 220 volt supply, the pressure switch timer, and a solenoid valve. So these are the requirement that we have seen. We have bursting disc, we have time delay unit, we have pressure gauges, we have pressure switches, we have relief valve, we have master valve, we have safety pin, we have time delay unit, we saw the function of a bursting disc, we saw the function of time delay unit, why pressure switches are provided, why pressure gauge is provided, why we have a non-return valve that is provided. So thank you so much. Thank you for your time. And I hope you have watched the regulation and requirement for the CO2 room, which I have already covered. Maybe in next video, I'll be covering yearly maintenance, 10 yearly maintenance, 5 yearly maintenance of CO2 system. So stay tuned. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. All the best.